You guys, today went really, really well.
I want you to hold me, kiss me slowly, like how you took a little time to get to know me.
Hey guys, I'm back here with my bad bitch, JT. He about to say bye. He leaving, going back to Charlotte.
I know.
Y'all be seeing him again when I go to Charlotte.
Very soon.
Exactly.
Maybe in a few weeks, who knows?
I know, right?
Or I might be like down here to wreck shit again.
I got one. Where you get the jacket from?
Fashion Nova.
For real? Mm-hmm. That's cute. That's
fashion.
I don't know
what people talking about.
That's right. Look at the drip chat with the Gucci shoes on. Oh.
No, it's
I'm a drip for sale. I'm gonna open the door for you.
Oh, yeah, it's getting pulled away.
I'm still standing.
Did I give you a hug?
No. Bye, JT. Okay, love you too. Let me know when you get home.
Okay, I will. Thank you for the hospitality and everything.
No problem.
Yeah, I'll call you if I get bored on the road.
All right.
If D-Bus don't tie me over.
Bye. Good morning, you guys. Excuse my acne. I'm like breaking out stupid bad, but I'm about to go to my first training session. I'm nervous about this. I don't know what to expect, but I know losing weight is on my goal. I know I get one free training session with my gym, but losing weight is on my vision board. My camera just cut off. Somebody called me. You know, I record from my iPhone. Whatever. But yeah, so here's to that. My trainer's name is Trey, and hopefully somebody keeps calling me. But like I said, my trainer's name is Trey. Hopefully he doesn't go extremely hard on me. But if he does, I need it. Because I have like gained a lot of weight, so it's time to whoop this booty back in shape. What's up, you guys? Please excuse my chin. Like, I'm breaking out super horribly. I don't know what's going on or why I'm breaking out, but whatever. I am sitting here looking at YouTube, and I just wanted to vlog for a little bit and tell you guys about my training experience. Like, so I wanted to fill you guys in on what happened at the gym today, because I had my free training course, or free workout, I guess, with the trainer, I should say. Everything went pretty good. If anything, it just put me in a mental standing to know where my health is as far as what I need to work on. They did my weight, they told me my BMI, my fat percentage, and a few other things that I just needed to know as far as how I can achieve my goals. And I have a little bit of a lower back problem from working these labor jobs. So he showed me some stretches on how to like work out my lower back and just stretch the muscles in my legs and stuff that's going to help me out. But yeah, you guys, I'm excited for this fitness journey because, you know, it's just been a long time coming. Like, I'm just excited about losing weight and trying to get in shape and just being a healthier me overall. I've struggled with, like, weight, like, all my life. But now I'm really serious about it and I'm just excited. Like I said, it's on my vision board, so it's one of the things that I want to accomplish for the year. We worked out like a 6-month plan for me to lose 50 pounds, but I'm gonna try to achieve as much as I can because it's the much weight. The more weight that I can shed, the better for me, the better for my health. Like I said, it's a little bit of a wake-up call, me just seeing like my stats and like where I stand at as far as like my body. But yeah, you guys, another thing I wanted to talk about is like I was looking back on some of my old photos, and I was skinty, okay? Like, skinny. Like, I'm gonna insert some pictures in here, like. There was a lot of people who would tell me that I was fat when I wasn't fat. And now looking back on it, you guys, like, you really have to watch your thoughts, because I really feel like I started to believe it. Not even feel, I did. I started to believe it, and like I said, people would tease me when I was growing up about my weight or whatever. And I look back, sometimes, some of my pictures, I was chunky. I'm not going to sit here and laugh. I always struggle with weight, like I said earlier. But there was times in my life where I'm like, fat weird girl, like, you look good. Like, I mean, I've always been bigger than the average, like, girl in my class or whatever have you. That never bothered me, but it just irritates me, because I'm like, at my skinniest moments, or my fittest moments, I should say, in my life, like, I still believe that I was fat, and I allowed myself to look at me, look at myself through other people's eyes. And I just feel like you should never allow people to get into your head, because F them. Like, forget what other people think about you. That's how I'm feeling now, like, all 2020, like, it's not about what other people think about you, it's but what you feel about yourself and what you know is true about yourself. Because if I could go back and whisper to Young Diamond, like, F them beeps. I ain't gonna be cussing, but forget them girls, forget them people that was talking crap about you. Like, be yourself, be your truth, love yourself. And lately I've been looking at a lot of these manifestation videos, and a lot of more so like readjusting the way that you think about yourself and the way that you think about life. And I'm excited. That's what I keep saying. 2020 is going to be a phenomenal year for me. I'm not claiming nothing less. I want my thoughts to be positive, so that way they can manifest into a positive reality. And yeah, I'm not going to hold you guys long and be blabbing on, but tomorrow I'm really excited, because I'm going to my first networking event in Atlanta, and I think this is going to be really good for me. I know this is going to be really good for me. And it's for music, and I'm just really excited to get out here and to network with these other creatives and be around like-minded people, because being around like-minded people is important, you know. Great minds think alike, all that good stuff. But I will get back with you guys tomorrow, and I'll show you guys a little bit of the networking experience if I can, without looking like a weird vlogger. Good morning, you guys. I'm about to go to my event too. I'm excited about this. Like, this is what I came to Atlanta for, to network, you know what I'm saying? So hopefully I'll go in here and make some good connections. I'll show you guys my outfits, but I don't got on nothing. Just some slides. I just got on a black dress with some tights and my boots and this jacket, thanks to my mom, she bought me. So another thing I'm gonna tell you guys, if you keep catching me in the same outfits on my vlog, that's because I had to leave most of my clothes in Las Vegas. And another thing was, oh, I'm not sweating on camera, but another thing was that, you know, the weather change in Vegas to here, like, it gets really cold on the East Coast because of the water. And in Vegas, you know, they don't got any water. Excuse me. I know this is so bougie, like, tapping my face, but I got to because I'm sweating. I always sweat. But, the change from Vegas to here, like, all my clothes is, like, summer clothes, spring clothes. I had a little bit of winter clothes, but not really. And now, it's all winter. So, please excuse me until I get my life together and get myself on track, you guys. Just ignore the outfits, all right? I'm an outfit repeater, hard. But yeah, I'm really excited about going to this event. I know things are gonna go well. I've been seeing a lot of repeating numbers. Like, I keep, like, on my cameras counting down, I just saw 111. I keep catching 111, so I'm taking that as a great sign from God. I'm excited about pushing my career, especially in Atlanta with the connections, you know what I'm saying? So, all right, I will show you guys, like I said, a little bit of the networking event. I'm gonna try to, like I said, without being an awkward vlogger, because filming and recording strangers that you know It's weird. But I'm gonna show you guys as much as I can, and I'll get back with you guys. Back in the house, I'm about to make me a little snack or something, because finally, freaking a train ride later and a few freaking buses, I'm back all the way back to my freaking house. Like, I can't wait to get a car here, because like living in Georgia and trying to bus it, excuse my makeup is everywhere, I'm about to go take a shower too, but living in Georgia and trying to like use the public transportation and not living like right smack dab in the middle of Atlanta is not the wave, like, at all. But anyways, you guys, today went really, really well at the networking event. I'm really happy that I met a lot of different creatives. I met a few producers, you know what I'm saying? You know, God is great. I am excited about this new journey. I'm excited about being around like-minded people. I cannot wait to take this lipstick off, y'all. I look wild. Anyways, but I'm excited about this new journey. I'm excited about being around like-minded people. I know God got something great planned for me, and I'm going to be filming more networking events that I go to. Like I said, the more comfortable I get vlogging, the better the inside scoop will be on these networking events, because, you know, like I said, it's a little weird trying to film people and I don't know them, but yeah, you guys, please, if you have any questions or if you want to see anything specific while I'm here in Atlanta, just leave it down below. You know, I like talking to you guys. I love, even I have a very small following right now, I'm fine with that. We'll grow, we're gonna be gang, like I say all the time, eventually. But you guys, please leave comments down below. Please like my video and subscribe to my channel if you watch me consistently, because you help my channel grow. The more people who like my video and subscribe and comment, the more YouTube pushes it out there. But thank you guys for watching my vlog again. I will get back with you guys again soon. I love you all. Peace. Get to know me.